hold it clear, they'll be able to, and oh my goodness, where it on the in the knife round straight away. And just a quick, oh, we're playing Inferno. And a quick reminder for those new to Counter-Strike, for those new to game Counter-Strike, the winner of the knife round gets to decide pretty much which half they're going to start off as. And as Inferno, we do know it is a CT-sided map, so the winner of the knife round will start off as CT. It looks like Berzerk will be doing that indeed.
Yeah, I suppose the chat test is a bit confusing to newer people,
yeah.
Definitely, that why people are running at each other with knives, but there you go. And we're going to see Publicir starting off on the terrorist side as Berzerk. They get to start as the counter-terrorists as we go live here into the pistol round. First round. And this is already, as we've seen previously, as we were building up to this point, the biggest deal. I mean, everyone says, oh, you know, the pistol round's important. You know, it's not telling us anything new, whatever. But it is important. You cannot take that away. It's such an important factor here, especially Publicir. They're coming off the loss. Berzerk as well, they came off a loss. But they came off of a fantastic performance against NIP, so they're
still feeling great. Exactly.
Whereas Publicir are not going to be feeling so great. And here we go. Action begins.
Push it. On spawn site, beat. Felix does a bit of damage. Will, with the help of Alex, get a kill. Felix will get a second, but both of them are now down. The bomb site is under control of the T's. It's 3-on-3, however, but the CTs have a pretty hard task of retaking the bomb site now from Publicir. So a good start for the Swedes. Late smoke, but Solik unable to get that kill coming into the bomb site. Crystal and Solik each with a kill each. Last man standing is Quicks. He'll be taken down by Asmol, and that's a solid retake there by the Germans. And 1-0 for the CTs.
This is so heartbreaking for Publicir. Very similar pistol round for them on the last time. I mean, it didn't go to the 1-on-1 like it did previously, but it was pretty close there. Could have gone either way. And it's going to be Berzerk, though, picking up that first and extremely crucial round there as the CT side. You really want to get that bank going as the CTs. You want to have as many nades as possible. You never want to be playing on the edge, economically speaking. Let's see how their setup is. It looks fairly defensive here, you know, fairly standard for the anti-eco, as we're seeing Publicir just amassing up Banana. Soon to push in. We're going to have Felix here on the defense. Look at the smoke there, ready to go out. There it is.
Bit of a late smoke there, but it does split the T side in two. And Pith trying to see if he can get a frag all the way in bomb site A will be unable. And Alex with not a bad double kill there.
So here we go. 2-0, as expected. Nothing out of the ordinary following the first round of pistol victory for Berzerk. They continue to build that economy. They didn't really lose much in terms of money. Only having to have two rebuys there. So they're doing all right. And we're seeing a pistol, we're seeing a full buy here because of the bomb plant on the first round from Publicir. This is the round they're dangerous in. This is the round that they really need to get some momentum going. They do not want to face that horrible spiral of despair that they had in the first match.
They've definitely learned from their mistakes. As you can see, a relatively, well, they're going for bomb site B right now. Without any flashes or smokes. Hofbrandl gets an entry frag on Felix, and that's a pretty good start indeed. I think they were trying to see if they can get them, you know, pretty much out of their element. Those flashes would be announcing their entry. But however, Alex does a great job getting two kills. Solid coming in all the way from CT spawn will get himself three, picking up that AK-47, perhaps the third. Yes, well, Asmo gets it. And that was far too fast for me. I was just about to say that Publicir did a great job surprising their opponents going into the T site, into the B site, but they took too long, and they placed the smoke too late. Solik was able to go through, and they took too long in killing Alex, and therefore the CTs were able to retake the bomb site relatively easily. So not as good as it could have been. And one thing I was going to mention as well, when I said that they were improving and they were changing, is that I thought they were probably going to use the flashes and smokes they had to their advantage. However, they went in dry, and perhaps it was for the better. But the CTs retaking the site, forcing the T side now onto an eco. But an early entry frag for them might be the start of something good, as Crystal picks up that AK-47. Or an M4, sorry.
A lot of action there, but considering the fact that it's actually a pistol round, Berzerk are expecting a committed play here coming in very soon, an aggressive, faster play, following that first pick onto Solik. But Publicir are taking this slow with the pistols. They're regrouping, they're getting ready, and there we go. Pistol able to rain down the bullets from Pit, and this is just so much time allowed for Berzerk to get in position. And
dear lord.
That seems like the, if you're going to call question into what Publicir were doing there, you can say, okay, you guys came together, you regrouped, that's great. But were you a bit too slow? A bit too slow there because Berzerk had such murdered. A perfect setup.
Yeah, it's a murder from behind there as they got completely destroyed at mid. And one thing that I forgot to mention was it was very nice there by Crystal to pick up the AK-47 to try and get it away from the T's. He didn't want them to pick it up. So well played by him. Getting his teammates, his fallen teammates' gun away from their prying hands. We have three CTs there at bombsite B, and it is a fast push into bombsite A. Again, Publicir play exactly the same way they did in the first game, and exactly the same way they've been playing from the start of this one. And to not much avail. They do have control of mid, but they have been given that control, that's for sure. And that smoke there in library, don't know exactly why it was done. Puffran pushing in from apartment. Didn't get himself a kill, putting it back onto a level playing ground. Pumpkins pushing in from truck side. He'll be able to get that spray down. Crystal will get the better of him. Now it's just 3-on-4.
And this is nice, actually. They're playing. This is a great setup for Plan B coming in here. They're making the push into the B-bomb site now because Quicks was able to push up, get that information. We can see that the most of the Berserk players are having to react to this. If they are quick, Publicir can pull this off, but Felix is the man to stop them. He was a monster against the Ninjas. Can he do exactly the same? Publicir looks like Puffran has the answer. This is such a tense situation. Alex able to get a pick right there, but Samster, he is the last man standing here for Publicir. They need this round badly. Can Samster pull this one off?
It's a 2-on-1 clutcher. Flash is turning on very much. Crystal is going to try and see if he can wall bang him through Spindle. But he peeks at the wrong moment and Crystal will get that relatively easy kill on Samster. Another round for Berzerk. Publicir a tad bit closer to winning a round.
Yep. One thing I'd like to illustrate, which I think was really great by Publicir, is that despite the play they made up mid, and this is it's not the straightest lines ever drawn in my life, but they made this play up mid, which was great. They're taking control. That was kind of where the first play came in. Of course, we saw that there was problems there. But because they had one man up here who was ready for any flanks or to catch any rotators, that guy also gave him the information and the other option, if stuff does go bad, to fall back. It's a great pick there from Solik, but overall, Publicir, they're playing very well. They obviously understand the game to a good level, but so far Berzerk executing out of their minds.
Yeah, I think in those one-on-one situations and two-on-one situations, it looks like Berzerk are getting the better of them through pure aim.
And it does seem to be that Felix, wow, Puffran brave with that peek, does take down Felix. Now this is certainly a good way to start the round for Publicir, getting that trade. So in that horrible corner there that no one ever checks, I swear. And that is going to even things up. That is a big deal for Berzerk, who now have things under control over at B. Gives Publicir a better picture, but still, this is much better for Berzerk right now.
Yeah, and it's a corner that the Publicir team themselves have been using a lot, so you'd expect them to check it. But now it's a 4-on-3 situation as we have the bomb going towards bombsite B through Banana. There is a smoke there by Alex. He does detect them coming. He has his flash out ready. Flash set. Slow them down. As Solik will get the kill on the T, who's marauding all the way at Ali. Now Publicir only have 20 seconds left on the clock. They have to go for a fast push into bombsite B if they're going to make it. But Alex is waiting for them. He's got a very good angle as well. However, Ponkus will get the better of him. He does quite a bit of damage. Almost. Actually, over 100 on both of them.
And they pull this off. They're staying well out of the way of those AWP angles. Very smart, because there is no smoke down. Very, very, very cognizant of that fact. Publicir ready to play this from Coils. Samster with the pick there over at Construction. Things are going well. Can he make it at 1-on-1? No, I can't believe it. Surely that was in the, you know, surely he could at least get the 1-on-1 there. That would have been the kind of saving play, but now we're seeing a Publicir who are being pushed into a very similar position as they were in the very first match we saw them in. And that is, we do not want to see that again.
It's unfortunate there. In that kind of situation, they didn't have a good angle and he did know exactly where the CT was. So he probably should have got the kill almost immediately when peeking. But sometimes things like that happen. A double nade down Banana. It's not going to meet anyone though. as the T's have gone for a standard split with actually more than one person than normal going towards bomb site A, and the bomb is going towards bomb site B. Are they going to go for a fake and try and plant the bomb on his own? Or did he just go there without knowing that he had the bomb? Puffrin,
that has to be
losing the bomb early on in the game, and that's a huge mistake there by Publicir. Definitely shouldn't have done that.
That was one of those errors you expect on matchmaking. That was one of those crazy oversights, and this could end up punishing Publicir on a very important buy round for them. They are absolutely out of money. Okay, they are the terrorist side. They're getting the consecutive round loss bonus for the money. Things aren't looking good. Great little flank through CT Arch there, catching the rotation of Asmo. This will give them the chance they need to come at this from two sides. That is the best case scenario. But Solek with the AWP! Oh, he's gonna catch Ponkus. No flank. And the bomb is just stuck there. What in God's name do they do in this spot? They surely must save.
They've got 25 seconds on the clock. They do know those smokes are going to run out sooner or later, and they think they're just going to try and go for it. If they're able to get the bomb, perhaps they can go for a rotate, and that's probably something they might be doing. Or are they going to keep them guessing? Pith peeking. 10 seconds left on the clock. They probably don't have enough time. They'll be able to take down Alex through brute force. And now the CTs are in a little trouble, and they've lost control of the bomb. 3 seconds left on the clock. Will the bomb be planted by the T side? Yes, it will, with 1 second left on. And now it's all up to Felix to get the round for Berzerk. Publicir probably getting their first round of the game. In a very, very interesting situation as well.
Oh, he got the dink on him. He got the headshot. He's going to get the kill onto Pythe. There is just one player left in Felix, who just became a monster in IP. He's carrying the momentum to the next game. Felix out to make a massive name for himself in this one-on-one situation. Quix has to be smart to play this right.
He's done a great job not peeking, and that's forced the CT side to lose that round when Felix should have just gone for the defuse, and he loses the AWP as well. Unable to save it. Quix with only 5 HP is able to go through that. But excellent job by Publicir, and excellent job by Quix, who didn't fall for any of Felix's little fakes.
Yeah, that decision to go for the bomb there in that position, that was incredibly risky and awkward, not only because they lost their flanker, but because there were so many nades on the side of Berzerk to deal with that. They had the Molotovs even. They had the perfect situation to deal with that. Everything inside me was screaming that shouldn't work, but they went for it. As awkward as it was, they did. Yeah. Now they're taking control, taking liberties of apartments. Looks like there is a response, denying map control, but the true intentions lie here on the B bomb site, but the defense goes down here as well. What options are Publicir left with?
Well, they do a lot of damage on Alex at least. However, that little burst of confidence that they got from the first round has, I think, dissipated, as now they're forced onto a 3-on-4 situation. Something you don't want to have early on in the round. There's 1 minute left on the clock, and it looks like they might be going towards bomb site D here. They do have a few flashes to play with, and one smoke. And well placed, they'll probably be able to block off CT spawn from that rotation. They do know that one of the bomb sites is going to have one less man than it usually does. But sadly, it's not going to be bomb site B as they push in pretty hard. Alex doesn't have a lot of HP. Will be finished off there by Puffrin. And now, will he be able to get the kill? Checking his gun at the wrong moment as Felix will be able to take him down. That's the biggest mistake they could have made this round. 2 against 3. The bomb has been planted, however. And at least they will have that boost into the economy. Asmo will get the revenge for Crystal. Now it's 1-on-2. Pith, unable to rise to the occasion, will lose the round. Felix and Asmo, barely 80 HP between them. And that's a round for Berzerk that shouldn't have been.
So just for anyone who's new, when you press the button to check out your weapon, that doesn't stop you from shooting it. But what it does do is kind of obscure your vision a bit to your crosshair, and it's uncomfortable. It's really weird. Usually the reaction is to switch away from the weapon to get back the weapon so it's just static again. Yeah. And so obviously that had to be just a misclick. That just had to be a misclick, and that was one that was a free frag. That could have been the difference for the round there. Now Definitely. They're on the eco. Now it's 7-1. Publicir, off of that mistake, getting just destroyed here. Running into their deaths. Maybe that was one of the rounds where we see some of the top teams saying, okay, let's just sit and spawn and talk to each other.
Yeah.
Let's talk to each other. Let's get the round going.
Yeah.
Because they know they're going to lose that one. And I feel like the temperament or the morale in Publicir, that's definitely seems a bit unstable right now.
Yep. The morale at the moment is very, very low for the side that is pretty much facing the same fate that it did against Team Epsilon. And I guess this is going to tell us something. This is going to tell us that Berzerk, in fact, are probably as good, if not better. They're playing a very, very solid CT side, but I've been making a lot of mistakes. I have no idea. Solik is there. He's going to get an easy double kill. Pistol is going to help him finish the job, and they completely destroy them. They have almost hardly any map awareness. On the other hand, Berzerk have full map awareness. They know exactly where they are, and they know exactly where to position the players. And right now, 9-1, it's not looking so dandy for the Swedes.
That was a really, really nice play from Solik there, because that's one of those risky plays where it's like either I win the round or I just die and I make my teammates' lives a bit terrible on the defense raid. They have to play for a delay game, wait for the rotation from B and stuff that really survived the retake or the stop the plant going down, because he's hiding behind the smoke and either you get behind the ranks by doing that or you just die because it goes a bit wrong because you can never even predict it. But it looks like it worked out, and this time we're seeing another pistol round coming out from public play, not where they want to be. Their economy is in tatters at the moment. They're still looking at a buy next round, but if they don't bring it back now, they are just, they're put to the same situation. We lose the first pistol round, we lose the game.
Yep, and it's just textbook CT play there by Berzerk. They're holding their angles, they're playing great support. Crystal there with an aid over Asmo to support them, and they're pretty much losing no men as well at the same time. But now there's a full buy by Public Clear, 10-1. They've got four more rounds left on this half. Will they be able to make anything of it? Make it into a 10-5? Or are they just going to crumble against this very, very strong CT side? Smokes go down a mid, and it's a smoke that you don't... Usually it's a lot tighter than that. It's a lot tighter than that. It's a bit all over the place. It's allowing the CTs to kind of go into the smoke, to move around, and actually use the smoke to their advantage rather than the advantage of the Ts. And that's something you have to be very, very careful of. But they do have control of apartments, and they are pushing towards mid. There are two men at truck side. And a good smoke there by the Ts. That's going to give them one less, or take one less angle away. Good push there by Samster. He will get the better of Solix. Not looking so bad at all at the moment. 4-4. Felix will be shot down by Piff. And now they have a legitimate chance of winning this round. But they do have to make the right choice. Are they going to go towards bombsite B, which is the better choice, or are they going to go towards A? Two CTs. They are aware of that. They do know they've left the bombsite, and they're pushing all the way towards bombsite B right now. Quicks will take down the last defender of the bombsite. And it's all up to Pip to stop this rotation in.
He's looking great there, but he's going to actually go down in that scenario, so it is a 2-on-3. This is pretty doable. They have a few nades. They've got a Molotov as well. If that's placed well, that could help. If they throw that deep into the back of the site on Ponkus' position, which is usually taken up by terrorists, that can work very well for them. But Crystal to take one down. He gets the second. Asmo's looking for the third. Pontus. Oh, there's the Molotov in the corner. What
dearie
a retake.
Dearie me. And he should... Asmo should not be alive. He should not be alive.
No.
I have no idea how Crystal was able to get that T who's behind them. But another round lost by Public Clear in a situation where they shouldn't have lost it. The CT is able to win a 2-on-3 retake of the bombsite. And I guess it's those clutch situations where we're seeing the higher level of CS from the German side and the much more organized German side, who are playing some very, very good CS at the moment. Very organized, very good communication, fast rotations, very tight movements into the bombsite, and really showing that they deserve to go through the group stage and that they have a legitimate chance of going through the group stage as well. Epsilon are going to be relatively worried if they lose against NiP. If not, it's going to be a NiP versus Berserker rematch. Quicks with an entry frag.
Yeah, that's a really good way to start things off. They need that. And it will get shut down, but they did remove the player from quad. That gives them a lot of options. It forces Berserk's defensive line all the way back. Smoke goes down. They can play this slow now, but there's only three of them left, so looks like they're going to commit onto this. And I see Pai waiting there. Pai's position is incredibly important. He's trying to make a kill, but he keeps himself alive. Crystal and Felix taking down the players inside. It's 1-on-4 for Pai. There's a tap down. Oh, I was looking almost, for the four man.
Almost.
But not quite.
Not bad by Pitt. They're almost getting a double kill. And Pitt is just one of those positions where you can just cause absolute havoc once you get control of it. And as we saw, Pith almost getting at least two kills. So, 12-1, with two more rounds left on this half, and Public Clear look like the, they look far from the favorites at the moment. You have an AWP on Solik. on there. Don't want to banana. It's just going to do a slight bit of damage on Puffer.
And Alex's position's very good with the pop back. And they smoke him off, and he's going to go nuts here with one crack. He doesn't avoid anything else, and the smoke is going to deny him any help, but that's okay. It does deny them the push in as well. So Berzerk are stabilizing, but with the man down, it does favor the terrorist side if they're able to make a good play together on a side. It's going to be Crystal to stop an aggression on mid. So things are going well for Berzerk now.
You're right, and the thing is, Publicir, they have to realize something. They can't put themselves in a situation where they're pushing in one man against one man in Berzerk, because, you know, without a doubt, it seems so far that Berzerk are pretty much winning every single one-on-one situation. The best they can do is go in either with flashes, either try and go in two at a time, or do something other than go in one-on-one and just let the Berserk side take them down one by one by one until the whole team is dead. And that's exactly what just happened in that round.
Most important concept in Counter-Strike, trades. That is what it's about. You have to always make a trade. If you're going for any kind of a risk, any kind of a peek, you have to have the ability to trade that frag. So it's not, because then you can gain the ground, you can push it, you can use it for something. It keeps the field like at an edge for you as the pushing team. Yeah. And this is, if you want to look at a team that does that the best, in my opinion, it's VODS. I feel like they have an amazing trade game. But look at this.
Two amazing shots there by Solik, both dragging down his cross set. Wolfram will be in a nice position to get himself a kill. But it's not enough to do anything. Quick is the last man standing with an AK-47 deep. T-ramp. There's nobody outside B, but the bomb is down at mid, behind the smoke. It's a one-on-two situation here. As Quicks will get really hurt by that nade. They're not exactly where he is. Interesting smoke. Maybe not really for his advantage, as Quicks still has clear sight of the CT. 50 seconds left on the clock. Nice flash there on second mid, in case somebody is peeking. Good job there by Quicks, but that pop slash from his teammate is going to render him blind, and Asmo will finish off the job. 14-1, and they're in a worse situation than they were against Epsilon.
Actually, there's like a quick tip I can quickly point out. When you make a smoke like this, Rick, it actually, in reality, it covers like just almost about three quarters of the entry. There's a gap. Now, this is a really, really good way to actually bait your opponent sometimes, because they want, you know, they want to peek you, and you're saying to them, well, you can peek here. So that means you know exactly where they're going to be to peek, and they don't know where you're going to be. We see this bait used in very high level very effectively sometimes.
Yes, that is true. We have information that Ninjas in Pajamas versus Epsilon ended 16-5 for the Swedes. Epsilon will be playing against the winner of this game, so it's most likely that we'll see a Berzerk versus Epsilon game. That's going to be a very close game indeed. However, so far, Berzerk seem like they're doing a better job playing against Publicir in exactly the same situation. It is Inferno, and they are starting off the CT side, and Pith with his CZ getting himself a double kill. Not bad there by Publicir on their first pistol round. It's 3-on-2. There are only two T's left. Bomb is down. Pith coming up from truck side to get the kill on Asmo. It's all up to Felix right now. This is a pretty good start by Publicir if they're able to win this round, but it's 1-on-2 and Felix is an absolute monster. Puffran, however, will deny him the ability to get that clutch, and it's 14-2. Is it a comeback?
Really saved by Pythair. Really, really saved. He managed to bring them back into that one, stop that crazy, crazy push down CT side towards Library from Berserk. But you're talking about comeback. You're talking about a huge comeback here. It can be done. It's been done. That's what makes CS exciting. But Publicir, I don't know if they have tight enough setups on the CT half to do that. We're gonna bear witness to what they have to show us in this sense. And this is a very spread out play here from Berserk, looking for picks here, pick up a weapon.
This is exactly how you're supposed to play a T side on Inferno. Very, very nice and keep your choices open and keep the CTs guessing. But it looks like they're going to be pushing towards bombside B. They do have a full buy. They're not giving Publicir any chances. Going for CZs and armor. And Publicir are going to be in a lot of trouble because they only have SMGs. They're not going to be able to do a lot of damage. But Punkus will get one kill, not the second. Nice work there by Punkus and Quicks. Quicks have completely shut down that push with an SMG and a shotgun. That's really, really well done by them, and something I didn't expect to see, actually.
The interesting thing about this is that Berzerk actually had the counterplay for what Publicir were doing, because they realized that Publicir wouldn't necessarily be playing with rifles.
Exactly.
And they did the pistol armor because they didn't get the plant. So actually, in this situation, Publicir, if they read into the metagame, in theory, you shouldn't be playing with too many SMGs, because as we could see, the bison was just doesn't care. It doesn't do much. So they were, I think, fairly lucky to actually bring that up successfully as they did. Yeah. So Publicir doing well and more or less here in Berzerk. And this next round from Berzerk, that's going to be scary. I'm interested to see what they're going to show us here, because against NIP, they're able to put NIP offenses to the limit.
Yep, definitely. But Publicir doing a good job. And one thing they did well the last round as well was peeking at the right moment and then hiding at the right moment. And that kind of put the terrorists a bit all over the place. They were checking right, left, checking, and they were peeking, and then they were coming out and firing shots, and they were kind of pretty much giving each other turns. They let the shotgun have a shot, and then the bison would do a spray down, and they'd switch. And it worked for them, and it worked in defeating that full armored push into bombsite B, which should have gone the other way, especially against an SMG defense. However, now we do have a full buy here by Berzerk. 5 AK-47s, full armor. This is going to be an aggressive, fast push. Here we see Publicir trying to take control of the bombsite. Quick's able to hide behind the car. They have no idea he's there. Will Quick do anything? Hit spray down, failing against Crystal. And that's a huge mistake by him, because now it's a 5-on-4 situation, and their defense is going to be spread tight.
It is going to be tough, but actually two players very low for Berzerk. And here they are now charging in to the site. And Felix here, the match really lost the game against NIP to take down Pipe there. And that smoke is really well placed for Berzerk as the bomb does go down. There's one player left hiding in the site still. And Puffran coming in with a good kill onto Crystal as Ponk is there, creeps in the site, looking for another terrorist to gun down. And here he's going to spot one. Felix comes in from behind, tapping him down. He can't quite get the kill quickly enough. Felix will survive, but Ponkus, he lives. And will this fight Felix in the backside, not taking him down earlier? There goes the grenade. That's got to be it, surely. Ooh, the dodge. Felix, he might have just done this. It looks like he has. He has sent Ponkus running, tail between legs, and he is going to allow his team to hold on with two health.
With only two health left. Not bad at all. However, for a moment there, Publicir did quite a good retake of that bomb site. In fact, did a lot more damage than I'd assumed they would. And Puffran doing a great job getting himself triple kill that round, especially with just the pistol. However, it's 15-4. This is match point, and it looks like Berzerk are most likely the team who will go through and have a second chance to exit this group. Piff going for the auto sniper.
Oh, here is the scar.
Let's see if Piff can do some damage with the scar. So if we get an entry kill there on Samster, they are pushing towards bombsite B, but it is actually the CTs having quite an aggressive position at Banana.
Yeah, they are actually stopping the push into the site so far, and it's looking pretty good for them. Although Quicks did just get picked off, they still have Puffran there providing the stop, and he's going to even push on the angle a little bit further as they have the bomb down. So 2-on-2, AWP versus AWP, Scar versus AK. This is interesting here for Publicir.
It looks
able
good.
To pull this off.
It looks good for the Scar, I think.
And the only reason that they're able to afford this is because they didn't have to rebuy nades. They didn't lose any men early on, but the bomb is still going to go down. Can Puffran pull out this AWP versus AWP situation? You never see this. You almost never see
bomb
this.
Bomb planted, AWP versus AWP. It's pretty much the whole hopes, all the hopes of Publicir are resting on the shoulders of Puffran, who hasn't switched for an AK-47, has no idea that he's in apartments. He does check every single position. He has to think, well, he must either be in the site or in apartments right now, or perhaps marauding in the end. He has no idea that he's right behind him. And a bit of an anti-climax there in the one-on-one, but Alex getting the final round in a very, very solid win against Publicir. 16-4 for the German side. And it looks like the next matchup is going to be Epsilon versus Berzerk. And that's a match definitely to watch.
It's going to be really, really good. I love some of the skill we got to see there. There was a fun little situation at the end there, just to kind of just explain it very simply. When that bomb plant was technically, it was really, really close to Boiler Room. And that's typically where you defend it from. And that situation, we've seen tournaments won and lost in those situations. That one-on-one defuse situation where you're, you know, messing around at Boiler, the guy's coming off and on the defuse. But he knew that he had quite a lot of time because the other guy was coming all the way from B. Yeah. So he's like, I'm just going to go in apartments. And as we can see there, that completely tricked the diffuser. So nice little thing there.
Yeah, little thing there. But at the same time, he checked every position, and he should have at least checked apartments, or at least pushed into apartments, because once you push into apartments, nobody's there. 100% is coming in from mid.
Yep.
He would have maybe got that round. But we are back to the groups, and as we can see, Nip versus Epsilon, Ninjas in Pajamas won 16-5. Berzerk versus Public Clear, 16-4. And the final is going to be Epsilon, or the winner of Epsilon versus Berzerk is going to go through to with Ninjas in Pajamas through Group A. However, about Group B, which we will be casting as well later today, it will be delayed by 30 minutes. The first game will start off at 8:30 instead of 8 o'clock. And as you can see, we have Fnatic versus SK, Virtus Pro versus LC, and it's most likely that we'll be casting Fnatic versus SK.
I'm really, really, really curious about London Conspiracy, the Norwegian team. They don't have Hoyland, but it's pretty much quite a fresh organization going there for them, and we haven't seen a huge, huge showing from the Norwegian scene, but the Scandinavian scene in general, they're just amazing at Counter-Strike. Those bastards.
Yeah.
Those bastards.
Why are they so good? You're not allowed to be so good.
It's in the blood, isn't it? There's only 9 million, let's say, Swedish people, but they have like such sick pools of players. It's crazy.
One of the strongest scenes, if not the strongest scene.
Yeah, there's no UK team. We've got like, 65 million people.
Too busy hating each other and fighting over breadcrumbs, I think. I don't know. We have no idea. We have no idea why that happens. And the same, I mean, look at the European scene and then look at the American scene. American scene's great. They've got a lot of top teams. But for the amount of people they have and the amount of people playing, it should be a lot stronger.
Definitely. So I'm really looking forward to this, because VODS Pro, to me, my personal opinion, they are the best team in the world right now, just from the recent results, just from the recent form that I saw from them in an online grand final, which was against Dignitas. I felt like I saw every single element of that is required to be a very, very top level team, and it was all mushed in together perfectly. Perfect synergy, just such amazing chemistry between the players. They were all clutching out of their minds. Their strategies were very intelligent. The way that they had able to adapt and read the other teams and go on the fly was also very amazing, as well as the set plays, and the way that they could influence the pace of the game. They could play very aggressively. They could play extremely hyper defensively, but they understand how to do it. They understand how to, play counter flash game, flash for one another and teammates. Yep. And this is something that we see a lot of teams in the top struggle with, because one of the problems with it is you need to have good chemistry and understanding of your own CT setups to do proper counter flashing. So for example, you really need to know exactly where your teammate's always playing. So if a rush comes in, you get the information, let's say it's Mirage, and a rush coming in slope, your guy who's in shadow has the perfect counter flashes. You're not peeking an angle to shoot people. Your job first is to flash him, because he's the guy with first contact. Then you peek out, someone else flashes for you, and then you peek out and shoot the flash guys. VODS Pro do that the best so that I've seen. So I'm really, really stoked. You can probably tell I'm quite excited to see
you
that.
You are very excited. I'm sure the viewers are feeling the excitement as well. And we hope that you enjoyed the cast for these two games, and that you'll be with us later at 8:30, as we will be casting, perhaps, I think it's most likely Fnatic versus SK. If not, we'll be casting the Virtus Pro game against London Conspiracy. It depends what the main channel is casting. We'll be casting the other one.
Definitely. Both will be fantastic matches.
So I think so as well.
You guys are going to have a great time. And of course, if there is any downtime, any delays, you can kill the time by checking out the Facebook platform. Play some CS yourself. I'm sure you've been inspired by some of the grand action that we've seen on the stream. You can jump on. And if you haven't played your placement matches to get ranked into a league, then you should do that on Facebook and see which league you are in, so you can play with people around your level. Get that 128 tick action going. Actually, when you're shooting someone in the head,
it actually hits them.
registration.
Yeah. So you don't have to just pray to the goddess CS every time you go for a spray down. Fair enough. But also, I'd love to hear, and I'm sure DDK would love to hear your opinion on the cast
and whatnot on the
Twitter. Sorry?
We'd love to hear about the most, which you think is
the most handsome stream. Yeah, sorry. But anyway, just like to show you guys about the Face It Weapon Skins project. The tournaments that Face It does and the money that Face It gets is from the sale of these skins, and they're awesome skins. They're designed by a weapons, who are they? Who are the guys design the...
Just various skins, guys who make skins. Like Caridian was the guy who made the P90, the Trigon. He got the, and that was where the first major, that's where the first Molina, a load of money came for the prize pool, so from Caridian skin, but it's any of the skin makers who are involved with the project. There's multiple skin makers.
Yeah, and we saw the Tech 9 Shatter. Please vote for it so we can get some money so we can make more tournaments and give it to awesome Counter-Strike players, and there'll be more awesome Counter-Strike for you guys to watch. Anyway, I guess that's it. We're going to have a break, and we'll be back with you at around 8:30, perhaps just before. Hopefully there won't be any delays. But thank you very much for watching. It's been a pleasure so far with Daniel, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. As I said, tweet us. What's your Twitter?
Follow DDK.
Mine is at Dr. Avela. Dr. Avela. Not a doctor yet, but
You're getting there.
I'm getting there. I put it just in case somebody makes it.
All right. I don't know if this is the best kind of pursuit to have, like, funny, awkward stories with medicine. Probably not. But what is your favorite thing about medicine? That's probably a bit safer.
My favorite.
Favorite thing about medicine. What's cool about medicine that people don't know? Because you're studying medicine, obviously, for those who didn't
earlier. You know what? I'll keep it nice and professional and say it's
helping
good to help
people.
It's good to help people. It's fun helping people. Well, there's a lot to talk about. Maybe for another time. Maybe we'll have this discussion in the future.
Yeah, he'll think about it during the break.
I'll think about it. I don't know whether it should be like a serious answer or like a comedic answer. It's something you have to sit down and kind of explain. My explanation for it is a bit...
We'll get some lectures going later on. Educate the masses. Yes. But for now, go to a break. Guys, we'll be back later. More awesome Counter-Strike action here on the Face of TV stream, the kind of B stream for DreamHack Summit. So see you later.